Hi, this is Karen Greenhouse, and today I'm going to be working with dynamic mathematics, basically showing you how you can use your technology, your graphing calculators, your projector and screen if you're a teacher, to visually help students see mathematics and make some discoveries on their own rather than just telling them to memorize. So I am using the graphing calculator app that Casio has. It coincides with our CG500 handheld calculator. So it's just an app. It's called the ClassPad app, but it basically is the, it goes with the handheld CG500. So this is the app. If you have the handheld calculator, this is what the menu items look like. Same thing if you're using the Prizm series, it's very similar. So you hit the graph menu and you come to the place where you need to actually enter in your functions. And I'm gonna work with a parent function. I like to do that because I think that's a great way for students to understand how coefficients and standard functions, etc., change the parent function. So I'm working with the parabola, so x squared, there's our parent function. And at the top, there's two different graph icons I can pick, and I'm gonna pick the first one, which is just gonna graph the function that I have there. So there's the parent function, and it's in blue. And then what I wanna do is really explore how you can use the modify feature that is in these handheld calculators and on the app in the handhelds themselves and actually dynamically move the coefficients to so students can see what's happening. So my next step would then be to actually start adding in those coefficients. Currently the coefficient is 1, but I'm going to start a second function that's going to change that. So I'm going to hit that second function, bring up my keyboard, and I'm going to enter in, instead of using a number, I'm going to use a variable for the coefficient. You'll see I'm sort of building that understanding of the standard form of the equation. So we're going to A to represent the coefficient, and then just back to our x squared. So all I've done is identified that I now have a variable for my coefficient instead of the 1 that's in the parent function. So get rid of the keyboard. So now I have this second function, ax squared, and that's my dynamic one because I used a variable, something that can change. So now I'm gonna hit that second icon, graph icon up at the top, that kind of looks like it has some movement on it. And once I click that, it's going to graph the current value. It's gonna basically have a default value when I click it, and you'll see over on the right hand side that it's defaulting to a value of 1 to start with. So that variable A has a value of 1. My coefficient has a value of 1. And it's lying right on top of the parent function because the parent function, the coefficient is assumed to be a 1, right? So I now have them look the same, but this is where the dynamic feature comes into play because I can simply move these arrows that are up there in the, excuse my little message board here. So basically A is now a slider or a variable that I can change by hitting the arrows left or right. So up there with that A. So if I hit the arrow in either direction, so if I want to go more positive, I'm just going to click it. And what you want students to be doing at this point is when you click it, making some conjectures, what's going to happen to the parent function, right? I'm changing that coefficient of 1. So when I make it more positive, so it's gone to a 2 now, it still opens up and it still is positive, and yet the red function, the one where I changed the coefficient, is now skinnier. I guess that's sort of how a student would describe it. So it looks like going positive is making the parabola close in, less open, skinnier, however they want to describe it. And this is the whole point of being able to use dynamic mathematics, where you can change variables and see the impact right away on what you've done, is it allows students to visually make some comparison, find some patterns, those types of things. Now what happens if we go to 0? Well, we have a red straight line, and that makes sense because 0 times x squared would be the quantity 0. What happens if I go negative? It goes down. And so students are starting to test some things. You know, what if I'm negative? What if I go more negative? Is it like when I went more positive? where it gets skinnier, so I can test those things very quickly. And so the beauty of dynamic mathematics on these types of graphing calculators that have that capability is that you can immediately make a conjecture and, using a quick arrow left right, test out that conjecture because you're using this modify feature. So again, I thought it would get skinnier and be pointing down because of the negative, and that is what happened. So now let's add to that. I'm going to go back to my modified equation, which is the red one because I'm using coefficients, and I'm going to add another coefficient. So again, I'm building that standard equation. So I'm going to add plus b. So I have to go into the narrow down to the letters when I'm in my keyboard. So I'm going to type in the b, and then I'm going to make it be x, so not x squared anymore. So we're just building on. So we're adding another term to our function, to our parent function. So once I do that, hit execute, and then again, I do have to, once it resets, I have to then choose the modify graph icon, which is the one, the second one up at the top there, and now it will show me the current red function at the current values. And remember, the default here is that the coefficients, the a and the b, automatically start as 1. So you'll see that because b is 1, my function is not lying on top of the parent. And that's because if you look at the parent function, it doesn't have a b value, it has 0 there. So in order for me to get that second function to lie on top of the parent function, I would need to change b to have a value of 0, because it doesn't exist in just the parent function by itself. So if I were to then, and this is a great exploration for students to have as well. So if I were to just go back and change that b value to 0, it would then lie on top of the parent function. And again, easy to do. All I have to do is hit the left or right arrow, and there I am. So now I can explore what happens with b. So we already know that a makes the function either open up or down, depending if it's positive or negative. It also makes it skinnier if it's a larger, more positive or more negative. So what's b doing to this function, right? What's b's impact on this parent function? So if I go positive, notice my function transforms to the left. So I'm going to get some ideas about that. And then I can make a conjecture, what would happen if I then went negative? If positive makes the function, parent function, translate to the left, then I'm going to conjecture that negative would make the function translate, however you want to think about it, to the right. So then I can test that out. We can again quickly move it to the negative to see that that is in fact what's happening. So you see, as I'm able to change that value, I'm testing my conjectures. I'm testing that, making that b variable, that coefficient of b, if I can modify it very quickly on the calculator. If I go right, it's because the b has become a negative. So I've made a connection here that positive b values, b coefficients, move my graph to the left and negative to the right. So let's add on that last piece of the standard form of the function for the parabola, which would be that c coefficient to stand for the constant. And so I add it in, and once I hit execute for that, it resets my graph. And then I do have to hit that second modify graph thing to basically tell the app that I'm modifying, I'm using modifications. And again, you'll see that the C value is automatically set to 1. We're going to put it to 0 so that it matches the parent. Now we can explore what does changing that constant coefficient do for us, so that constant variable. And so as I get more positive, it looks like that I am translating my whole parent function up. So the more positive I am moving up. And notice that it seems to move with the value that I chose. So if I choose 2, it moves up 2. If I choose 3, it moves up 3. So then my conjecture might be, if I'm a student, that if I want to move down, if I want to translate my parent function down, I'm going to use negative numbers. So let's just test that out. And again, here's the beauty of the dynamic mathematics, is that I can immediately make a conjecture and immediately test it simply by pushing some arrows. So if you notice, I'm going to go into my negative numbers to basically justify or prove what my conjecture was saying, that if I use negative numbers for that constant, that it's going down. So this is where you really can use your dynamic maths to help students see math